Okay, we're going to continue with factoring out the greatest common factor, but we're going to do some problems where the first term might be a negative sign. So for instance, here's an example, -6x plus 9. You can factor out between the 6 and the 9 3, and then that would give you -2x to get back to the -6x. And plus 3. That's perfectly correct. Also notice that because of the commutative property, you could write -2x plus 3 as 3 minus 2x, which, if you did the distributive property, you would get 9 minus 6x, which of course should get you right back to the original problem if you did the commutative property again, -6x plus 9. Now, so the tricky thing is there's all these different ways of writing the same thing, -6x plus 9. Using what you know about the associative property of addition, you could also write things a little bit differently. But in general, I want to go over, is there another way to write -6x plus 9 in a factored form so that the first thing in parentheses isn't going to have a negative sign. So let's take this off. Well, I could pull out a 3, or if the first term as it's written originally happens to be negative, you might want to just write, pull out a negative 3 as opposed to pulling out a positive 3. Then you would say negative 3 times what will give me -6x. That will be a 2x. And then negative 3 times what gives you negative 9. That would be minus 3. And you can check. So we're factoring out a negative sign here. Both of these are factored forms. And in fact, this also is factored, correct? These are all factored. They're all correct. Three different ways to factor -6x plus 9. Okay, let's do another one. What I want you to do here is to factor out the greatest common factor, but if there's a minus sign in front, pull out the minus sign. So try this on your own, put it on pause, then come back. Okay, since it starts with a negative, I'm going to pull out a negative. Then between 9 and 12, I've got 3. And then between x squared and x, I could pull out an x. You say, what do I have to multiply by to get back to that? I'll need a 3x to get the negative 9x. Now, I've got a negative 3 times what will give me a negative 12. That'll be a plus 4, and that'll do it. Negative 3x times 4 is negative 12x. So that's the answer. All right. Try this one. Okay. Factor this. And since the first term happens to be a negative, I want to have you pull out a negative sign. Put it on pause and try that. Okay, so instead of pulling out, let's see, an 8 is the greatest common factor between 16, 24, and 8. Let's pull out a negative 8. So the first term will be 2. Oops, I'm sorry. Forgot to do the variables. I have an a squared, an a, so I can pull out a, b, b to the fourth, and b, I can pull out a b. Now let's do it. So I have to multiply by a 2a to get back to negative 16a squared b, and this will have to be a minus 3b cubed and a minus 1. You can convince yourself by doing the distributive property to make sure you get the same answer. You might notice that when you pull a negative sign out in front of something and then do the parentheses, the original terms, notice here, are negative, then positive, and then positive will be opposite signs. You'll end up with a positive, a negative, and then a negative. Let's just practice factoring out a negative 1 from a polynomial. So in other words, as if there that is the greatest common factor is 1 or negative 1. So for this first term, since it's negative, you can pull out a negative 1. And you just basically change both signs and write the same thing. And you can convince yourself by doing the distributive property that that really is still negative 3x plus 14. Now for the second one, 5x minus 8, that looks extremely simplified to me, but you can also write it in factored form with a negative 1 outside in front, which means that would be a negative 5x and a plus 8 inside the parentheses. So how would you do this problem? Factor out a negative 1 and try it. You would have negative 1, 3x, plus 16. To find the opposite of a polynomial, you can simply multiply negative 1. And when you do this, the terms will end up having different signs, opposite signs. So for instance, take the polynomial 3x minus 9. When you multiply by negative 1, imagine doing negative 1 times 3x minus 9. Right, you would get negative 3x plus 9. You would get the same polynomial with opposite signs. And in this case, just notice that this could also be written as 9 minus 3x. Something's interesting here. If you have a binomial with a minus sign in front of it, when you take its opposite, just switch the order and you'll have the opposites. Okay, let's try another one. What if I had 4y minus 3? All right, the opposite would be negative 4y plus 3 or 3 minus 4y. It's important to recognize opposites when you're doing factoring. So if you notice that you've got some polynomial 4y minus 3 and somewhere else you see 3 minus 4y, it's going to become important for you to realize those are simply opposites of each other, which means if you multiplied one of them by negative 1, you would get the other one. So it becomes important for you to be able to do this. If you're looking at something that is 3x minus 11, it's important for you to realize that that's the same thing as negative 1 times 11 minus 3x. So watch what that's saying. I'm factoring it by putting a negative 1 out in front, but I'm switching the order. This does not work if this is a plus sign here. If only if it's a minus sign. You could convince yourself this is the same thing. Let's get another one. 7y minus 8. Again, notice because there's a minus sign, another way of being able to write that is a negative 1 times 8 minus 7y. Okay, try this one. Eight m minus 4x can also be written as negative 1 times what? 4x minus 8m. Now, I didn't say that's the best factored form. What I am saying is that's another way to write the same thing. If you were asked to factor 8m minus 4x, if the problem would just had been factor 8m minus 4x, you would take the greatest common factor of 4 out and write 2m minus x. All right, so what I'm saying is you can recognize any two terms with a minus sign in front of it could be written as negative 1 and then switch the order of the terms. That's going to be important to do a little bit later.